What we are looking at here is the excavation that prepares for the new access for members of the Legislative Council in particular to the chambers from the annex. The excavation goes down about 5.5 to 6 metres. Because the building sits on the ground without proper foundations, so very carefully we've had to do a lot of underpinning, creating a lacework of board piers to maintain the structural integrity. All of the tooling for the job had to be pretty much tailor-made, in particular to be able to drill vertically deep enough without disturbing the 160-year-old structure above, drill there and pour the piers and create the framework about. Even the excavation machinery has to operate on electricity. Because of the confined space, we can't use engines here. As part of the excavation, of course, like everything that happens in Parliament House, there is as much archaeology as there is architecture. And these are the remnants of an old drain. You can see the brickwork that contained the bottom layer of bricks. And this was one of the storm water drains. Anytime that we find any of these structures, it's about carefully documenting them and working with our partners in Heritage Victoria to see how we're going to treat them. In various parts of the building, those have been preserved if they have enough integrity, and they are repaired so that they can actually continue to perform the same function that was originally intended. That is the new lift shaft, and that shaft was created by removing one of the staircases that goes up to the top of the building. Parliament House was not finished, the construction was never completed to the intended Knight and Kerr design, and one of the penalties has been that the east wing of the building doesn't comply to building codes, didn't have proper fire escapes, there was no vertical access that could go through every floor, and it was most certainly not compliant with disability access legislation and requirements. So all of this work is actually about getting a 160-year-old building to be habitable and usable into the future, complying to contemporary standards. So we still have the beautiful heritage building, but being able to function in a contemporary setting over the next 60, 70, 80 years, or however long it needs to continue.